So today we are going to discuss about the pigeonhole principle and we will see an application of the pigeonhole principle. So what does the pigeonhole principle states? The pigeonhole principle states that if there are n holes and n plus 1 pigeons, then there is at least a hole with more than one pigeon. Well, that is pretty easy to understand, isn't it? So if there are two holes and three pigeons, what will you naturally do? You will select a pigeon for the first hole and a pigeon for the second hole, and then you are left with one more pigeon, which you will place either in the first hole or in the second hole. In this case, let's say I fill the second hole with that pigeon. So my second hole satisfies the criteria that it has more than one pigeon, and so it is pretty easy to see that if there are n holes and n plus 1 pigeons, there is at least a hole with more than one pigeon. So how about seeing the generalized version of this principle? So the generalized version of this principle states that if there are n holes and kn plus 1 pigeons, then there is at least a hole with at least k plus 1 pigeons. So how does this principle look like? If we take an example, so let's say there are three holes and let's say there are seven pigeons. So there will be a hole that has at least four pigeons, or rather three pigeons, that will have at least three pigeons. Now why so? Because 7 is 2 times 3 plus 1. So k plus 1 should be 2 plus 1, which is 3 pigeons. So we have now seen the generalized pigeonhole principle as well. Now let us solve a problem with the help of the generalized pigeonhole principle. So it's a very famous problem known as the Ramsey problem, and it states that among six persons there are always three who are either complete strangers or who know each other. So how to solve this problem? Now let us first draw a very colorful hexagon. So we will try and draw a very colorful hexagon for this problem. Here we go. I'm trying to draw a very colorful hexagon. Okay, so we have a very colorful hexagon like this. Now, let us join all the vertices of the hexagon with either the color red or the color blue. So we join it like this. Now what we say is that the vertices of the hexagon necessarily denotes the six persons, and if there is a red edge between two vertices, that means the two persons don't know each other, and if there is a blue edge, then the two persons know each other. So now let us take a random vertex of this hexagon. Now, from any random vertex, there should be five edges because we have joined all the vertices with all the other vertices of that hexagon. So that means taking any random vertex means that there will be five edges from that vertex. So five edges like this. Now I say that I have 5 edges and I have 2 colors, and 5 can be written as 2 into 2 plus 1. So I have 5 edges and 2 colors. So it pretty much seems like 5 is of the form kn plus 1, where n is 2 and k is 2 as well, and I have 2 colors. So there is at least 2 plus 1 or 3 edges of the same color by the generalized pigeonhole principle. So that means from a random